one click is all it takes to lose everything.
We are in a cyber war. You can either be a defendant or you could be a victim.
Another thing you want to make sure that you and your kids are aware of is everyone is doing cyber background checks. Do you realize colleges, companies, when they hire you, they're going in and looking at your social media profile. They're going in and looking at information you post, and they're using that to make decisions of whether you should be hired or whether you should be accepted to the college of your choice. I looked at some recent numbers, and do you realize approximately 21% of kids are not getting into the college of their choice because of information they posted online, because of social media profiles where the college looked at their grades, looked at their test scores, looked at everything and said, we're going to offer them a letter. And then they looked at their cyber profile, their cyber background, their social media, and they said, yeah, we're going to pass. Usually it involves things like partying, inappropriate statements, aggressiveness, violence, anything like that, where they just think it's too much of a risk. Remember, there are so many kids applying to colleges. Colleges can be picky. Colleges can be choosy. If they have two equivalent folks, two equivalent students, similar grades, similar backgrounds, and one of them has pictures at the age of 16 holding beer and partying, and the other one doesn't, unfortunately, I'm not saying it's right, but who do you think they're going to pick? So you need to make sure your kids are aware that they might think they're just having fun. They might think they're out there with some friends, but one picture taken by somebody else in which they're tagged, unfortunately, can ruin their life. So we need to just recognize and make sure that we're super careful. Now, the scariest part is, yes, other people can take pictures of us and post them online. So we always have to make sure who we're at, who we're with, and who's snapping pictures. Just based on the work that I do, I am always careful because I never know who has a camera and who's trying to snap an embarrassing picture. You always have to be aware. But the funny, scary part is most of the stuff on social media that colleges are using to deny kids acceptance are pictures they took. They thought it was funny. They thought it was cute. They thought it was humorous. But remember, things that seem funny today, taking out of context 2 years from now, can get you in a whole lot of trouble. So be super careful. And adults, no exception. Do you realize our numbers are a little worse? Do you realize approximately 37% of companies are not hiring you for your ideal job because of information you posted on social media, because of your cyber background check? And I'm not really shocked with that. I look at some friends and families and other folks, people post and say stupid things online. I sometimes read this stuff going, seriously, do you realize it's public? Now, yes, we sometimes think we're joking around or we're having fun, but things can be taken out of context. So be careful. Now, yes, I had one person say, Eric, I stand behind my political views. I stand behind my opinions. And if a company doesn't want to hire me because of my beliefs, I don't want to work there. And you know what I say to them? Awesome. If you are consciously aware that your decisions could impact your life and you are accepting that risk, knowing that exposure exists, then awesome. I am proud of you and you should stand for your beliefs. And I want to give you a high five, because we need more people that have that level of conviction. The problem is most people aren't at that level. Most people tell me, Eric, if I knew that information would be used against me, if I knew I wouldn't get my job, I would have never posted it. I would have never said it. So we just have to be a lot more aware. Things we would never say or tell people to their face, for some reason online, we think it's okay to say. So always show respect. Always put your best foot forward and always be careful of what you're posting, because it can and will be used against you. In addition to recognizing that anything you say and do online can and will be used against you, there's one other important point. On the internet, in cyberspace, on computers, there is no delete button. Repeat after me. There is no delete button. You might be able to delete it from your account. Yes, you can go into social media and you can delete something, but it's not gone. It's still out there on the internet. Yes, you can go into your computer and you can delete something, but it can still be recovered and it's still on the servers. So one thing I always want you to remember, before you hit send, save, or post, ask yourself, do you want this information to live forever? And if not, don't send it. How many times have you sent an email and an hour or two or next day you regret having sent it? You go, I wish I didn't do it. What I always do with any emails that have any tension or any emotion, I will write them and I will sit on them for 24 hours. I'll then come back later and say, do I really want to send this? And I tell you, 9 times out of 10, I delete it and pick up the phone. Also with social media, I love having a good time. You probably get to have a weird sense of humor. I joke around a lot and I really don't mean any harm. But I tell you, I am super careful of what I do, because early on, I would put some jokes, do some things that I thought was funny, and I forgot how many people around the world are watching it. And I got so upset because I actually hurt people's feelings. That was never my intent. I never wanted to do that, but I never thought about the long-term implications. So now, even though I like joking around and having fun, I am super careful of what I do and what I say. Now, yes, just because I'm the E-dog, I'm sure I'm still gonna get somebody upset periodically. I'm gonna cross that line, but I try to be careful and I try to be a lot more aware. So I want you to do the same thing. Recognize that not only is all the information public, but there is no delete button. You cannot get rid of that. I've seen people who have gone in and put up tweets and an hour later they've deleted it and you can still find them today. Not picking on anybody here, but especially with Twitter, right? There might be a certain individual who might live in the White House, who might often do an excessive number of tweets, right? And there's been some cases where he's deleted them shortly after. And guess what? They're still out there. The media still has them. So learn from the President of the United States. Once you hit send, it's very hard to recover and get it back. So be careful, be safe, and always remember there is no delete button. So make sure this is a message you want to live forever before you hit send, save, or post. And together, we can make cyberspace a safe place to live, work, and raise a family.